Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the 22nd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of mercy to all who call to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come, like a thief at night. When people are saying, peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. For God did not destine us for wrath, but to gain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that, whether we are awake or asleep, we may live together with Him. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, as indeed you do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate His temple.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited His people. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went down to Capernaum, a town of Galilee. He taught them on the Sabbath, and they were astonished at His teaching, because He spoke with authority. In the synagogue there was a man with the spirit of an unclean demon, and he cried out in a loud voice, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Be quiet, come out of him." Then the demon threw the man down in front of them and came out of him, without doing him any harm. They were all amazed and said to one another, "What is there about his word? For with authority and power he commands the unclean spirits. They come out, and they come out." And news of him spread everywhere in the surrounding region. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
At kagaya nga ho ng nasabi natin kahapon, ano, na nagbabasa tayo mula ngayon sa Ebanghelyo ni San Lucas, at dito yung simula nung public ministry ng Panginoon. No? He begins now his ministry in the Gospel of Luke. No? So yesterday you have that very beautiful prophecy, no, from Isaiah, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me." And now you have one of his first actions, no, during his ministry, aside from the preaching that happened yesterday in the gospel yesterday. Now he expels a demon, no? He exorcises or drives out a demon. So ito yung pangalawang masasabi natin ginawa niya, no? Pero kauna-unahan niyang action, no, matapos siyang magturo kahapon. Hindi ito aksidente, no, na ang kauna-unahang ginawa ng Panginoon ay ang pagpapalayas ng masamang espiritu dun sa tao, dun sa lalaki. Sabi nga sa amin nung teacher namin sa New Testament at saka sa Gospels, no. Sabi niya itong ginawa ng Panginoon ay nagpapahiwatig ng isa sa pinaka buod, no, ng trabaho ng Panginoon, ng misyon ng Panginoon at ng simbahan. Yan ang pagtutunggali ng kabutihan at kasamaan. At ang pagpapalayas ng misyon ng simbahan, ng misyon ni Jesus, ng kasamaan. Ano? I think it's a very important point to emphasize that, you know, as our scripture professor told us, that this is not a small detail, but it does define a major theme in the ministry of Christ, that battle between good and evil. And I think it's a good reminder to us because this battle is ongoing now, no? It is still continuing, this battle that we are waging against the virus, that is part of that mission of the church, no? To overcome evil, to overcome whatever, in a sense, no, gives burden to humanity, whatever evil is caused, that is part of the mission of the church. So bahagi pa ito ng masasabi natin na kasamaan na kailangan natin labanan, ano? At hindi lamang yung virus, kundi yung maraming pagpapasakit na dinulot nitong virus. Kawalan ng trabaho, pagsasara ng mga negosyo, gutom, at sari-sari pang problema na hinaharap dahil nga dito sa lockdown, dahil sa pagbagal ng ekonomiya, no? So I think it is really something that we need to seriously reflect on, that first of all, we must acknowledge the crisis and the evil of the crisis, different crises that this pandemic has brought upon us, no? And for us to find ways to overcome these evils. And again, I just want to repeat, no, what the Pope constantly mentions, no, that we must build a better future. We must not simply overcome the virus. We must not simply find a way to achieve herd immunity, to find a cure for the virus, but we must also rebuild the structures of society, the structures that has shown what is inherently unjust and therefore evil within the structures of society. Hindi lamang ho sa lipunan natin dito sa Pilipinas, kundi sa buong mundo. Pero dapat ay talagang suriin natin ano ba ang mga kasamaan at kawalan ng hustisya ang nasa napapasaloob, no, sa mga istruktura ng ating lipunan. Makikita natin 'to, 'di ba? Araw-araw sa news, 'di ba, yung mga paratang ng korupsyon, yung mga paratang ng kakulangan ng plano, at sari-sari, no? Sari-saring ano, mahalaga na ating kumbaga mapagnilaya ng lahat ng ito. At isipin natin ano ba ang ating pamamaraan upang madaig natin ang kasamaan ng kabutihan. I think when you look all around us, there is so much, really, no, so much news that disturbs us, no, the whole question of the COA reports, the whole question of the nurses, no, not being given the proper allowances, etc. I think we must be aware, but we must also discern how to overcome all of these challenges with good. It is not simply defeating the virus, but it is really building a better order. That is the continuing battle between good and evil as the gospel today tells us. So pagdasal natin na sana ay lahat tayo ay maging bahagi, no, nitong pagtutunggali ng kabutihan at kasamaan at talunin at lampasan natin ang lahat ng kasamaan na dulot ng pandemya. May we become all, in a sense, soldiers of Christ in this battle between good and evil. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Through the gospel, Christ speaks to us with words of eternal authority and deeds of healing power. Through him, let us pray with confidence, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to teach Christ's truth and combat the evils of our time, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may promote righteousness in their governments and be zealous in eradicating evils in the societies they are sworn to serve, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who suffer may be freed from their bodily or spiritual afflictions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And again, we pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our prayer for the 2022 elections. Diyos aming Ama, sa paghahanda namin para sa aming halalan 2022, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Jesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng naghahangad ng katungkulan upang maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na uunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami, lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina, higit sa anumang interes na pansarili o para sa grupo. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na maghahangad ng katungkulan upang tunay na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan mo ang aming mga isip at puso nang aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at kung ano ang pinapangako ng mga kandidato at ang kanilang kakayahang isakatuparan ng mga ito. Nang aming piliin ang tama ang mga pinuno na tunay na mamumuno at maglilingkod, mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa, at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung ano ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kaluwalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa oras na ito ng aming paghahanda para sa darating na halalan. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May these sacred offerings, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love, we celebrate His death. With living faith, we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise You, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of Your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is He who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down Your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that He was betrayed and entered willingly into His passion, He took bread, He gave You thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is My body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice. Again, He gave You thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of My blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of Me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim Your death, O Lord, and profess Your resurrection until You come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer You, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank You for counting us worthy to stand in Your presence and minister to You. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, Your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people Your Son has gained for You. Remember, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in Your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of Your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased You throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify You through Your Son, Jesus Christ. Through Him, with Him, and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is Yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be Your name. Your kingdom come, Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In Your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are Yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, You said to Your apostles, "I leave you peace, My peace I give you." Lord, we beg You not to look on our sins, but on the faith of Your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of Your kingdom, where You live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too, and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Siguro ho, nais ko lang magbigay ng konting update. Ano? Sabi nga ho natin nung linggo, nakakollect na tayo magbuhat noong Lent, no? Noong Ash Wednesday ng 30.277 million. Ano? Noong nakaraang, kung natatandaan niyo, noong nakaraang Holy Week ba, noong nag-lockdown, sumuporta tayo sa mga Caritas Kindness Stations. Ito yung community pantry ng Caritas na actually mula pa noong 2020 ginagawa na nila to. So tumulong tayo sa 66 na dioceses at nagmahagi tayo ng 5,250,000, no? At nagkaroon ng 161 Caritas Stations. At bukod sa stations, merong mas maliliit na mga stores, 40 stores. Ang actual hong na natulungan ng mga individuals is 512,745 individuals. At ang nakakatuwa ho, dahil nga sinimulan ng mga simbahan ng sila yung unang nagbigay ng seed money, 100,000 each sa mga diocese. Marami hong nag-donate in kind, no, pati yung tulong nila. Monetized, it is around 48.23 million, no? Yung mga donations sa local dioceses, ho, ano? And then, bahagi ho rin na ating binudget na ay para do sa feeding program for 300 families. So around 5 per family average of 1,500 persons for 120 days in 6 dioceses. So, 12.9 million including yung mga social workers, the admin costs, and this will be for 120 days, but actually one whole year yung program, including family development. And then po sa Ale Capo Educational Assistance Program, we have 525 scholars for the school year in 11 dioceses, and we are going to support them for 2 years. Ito ang budget for 2 years is 11 million, no? We will give them 1,000 pesos a month for 10 months for the coming 2 school years. Again, kasama ho yung mga mobilization, admin, and follow-up costs dito. Maraming salamat po, and Caritas Philippines is very grateful because without your support, they would not even have really planned and pushed for this big project. And hopefully, we can replicate this in other areas. So thank you very much and have a good day. We'll give you more details in the coming days. Thank you.
Purihin ang Diyos at magpasalamat tayo sa Kanya. Ipapatupad na po natin ang ating Ale Kapwa Legacy Program ng Caritas Pilipinas, Pamilya Feeding Program, at Educational Assistance Program para sa ating mga kabataan. 6 na mga dioceses ang tatanggap ng tulong para sa Pamilya Feeding Program. Ang dioceses ng Kidapawan, Cotabato, Capiz, Dumaguete, Infanta, at Libmanan. Bawat pamilya po ay bibigyan natin ng 300 pesos every day. At ang bawat diocese ay pipiliin natin ang mga beneficiaries, 60 families for every diocese. At itong tulong ay ibibigay natin for 6 months. Para naman sa ating Educational Assistance Program, 10 mga dioceses ang bibigyan natin ng tulong. Ang dioceses ng Bontoc, Basilan, Polo, Marawi, Libmanan, Infanta, Dumaguete, Capiz, Cotabato, at Kidapawan. Bawat diocese po ay pipili ng 50 na mga kabataan. At ang bawat bata na ating tutulungan ay bibigyan natin ng 10,000 pesos. At maliban dyan, ay tutulungan pa natin na magkaroon sila ng mga gadgets para sa kanilang pag-aaral. Ang lahat po nito ay ating ginagawa upang ang ating mga kababayan ay maiangat natin sa kanilang paghihirap at mabigyan natin ng magandang kinabukasan ang ating mga kabataan. Tulungan niyo po ang Caritas Pilipinas. Magtulungan po tayo para sa ating bayan. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.